good grief, I looked out here and Buddy's just like trashed. I was like, wow, is he laying out by the fence? I'm assuming he's taking a nap next to I just fed him. Ransom's not standing by him. I don't see his tail moving. I hate to disturb him if he's just sleeping, but wow, he laid right next to that fence. I just petted him and fed him. Good grief, if he dropped dead that quick, I'd be like, what the hell's going on? Buddy? Buddy? I'm sorry, bud. You look so freaking dead when you sleep. Good grief, that horse is trying to give me a damn heart attack. Oh my goodness. I looked outside and I said, holy shit, they were just standing up eating. He laid down fast. Crazy horse. He loves doing his dead dog impression. Ransom, why didn't you tell me he was alive? He's like, that crazy horse lays down and sleeps more than anybody I know. I'm sorry, bud. You're okay. I'll leave you alone. Let's see if Ransom makes him get up or encroaches on him. Ransom's like, I got your back. Go ahead and go back to sleep, man. I'll keep the stupid human away. All right, well, I guess he was just sleeping. Rick, you worry too much. Whatever. Freaking paranoid after losing poor old Mr. D. Shit, I couldn't remember. I was upstairs making a video. I looked outside and went, what the hell? I couldn't tell if it was Ransom or Buddy. And I went, man, he looks like he's laying by the fence. I hope he didn't get caught up in the fence and struggled. Wow. Okay, the vet's coming out today, by the way, for Ransom's teeth. She hasn't told me what time, but she said it'll be today. All right, talk to y'all later. All right, so Mookie's up here cleaning himself. See a little cardinal out there? I'm telling you, if you want the little cardinals to come around, throw some old popcorn. If I fix a bag of popcorn, I keep like the little kernels and I don't need the full bag. So I just dump it right out there and those, I used to damp it right here, but then Moki would ambush him, he'd sit up there. So I moved out there to where they got a better chance. And man, those little cardinals seem to love that popcorn. I know they like sunflower seeds, but man, they really like that little popcorn for sure. I don't know if he's coming out. Where's Moki going? I gotta warn a little bird if he goes out there. So I just gave the boys a little bit of grain. They were sitting in their little stall. Buddy hasn't been at stall hardly at all. They've been out there in the heat, roaming around. It's like, I wanna say it's 89 or 90 out here today. And they haven't been in the stall hardly at all. So I'm happy about that. Buddy's getting some salt. Maybe those little cardinals like that popcorn because it got salt on it too. Ransom, you know if Buddy left that bucket, there ain't no food in there. But Ransom is like, oh, hell no. There might be one little kernel. He is a chow hound mofo. It is freaking hot out there, let me tell you. All right, we'll add this in somewhere. Wow, it's really hot out here. I brought them both in to give them a bath. Look what Ransom looks like. I have not hosed down any area yet. You can tell it's all dry. This is how much Ransom is sweating out here. Wow. So Buddy's sweating pretty good, but not as bad as Ransom. You can see Buddy getting a little sweat spots down the side and stuff. But Ransom is just soaking wet, sweating so hot. So I brought him in shade here and I'm gonna get the hose out. give them a nice hose down. That'll relax them. Okay, so we got the poor little bells over there crying for them. Got them good and hosed off. Now they're kind of relaxing. I know they feel more comfortable after they got a good dripping. I haven't scraped them down yet, but I rinsed all that sweat off their faces and back. Man, they were really, a lot of sweat came off them. Till Buddy's still dripping under his belly there. So is Ransom. So that's where all the water goes and it heats up. That's why I gotta get a scraper. And I'm gonna scrape them off. And then I'll let them stand here for a few minutes, cool off, and then I'll let them back outside. But they're in the shade now. There's no wind. But at least all that salt's not blocking their, you know, they can cool better now. And I'm sure they feel better. Buddy, don't go get in trouble now. All right, let me go get the scraper. Oh, you know what? I have my scraper right out here, maybe. Nope, I'll put it up. All right, let me go get the scraper. Okay, so they're both kind of hosed off and scraped down with the water scraper or sweat scraper. And they're standing there like, oh, it feels pretty good, Dad. I was really mean. So they're both, their back legs are cocked. I don't know if you guys can see that. He's got one cocked and Buddy's got one cocked. Buddy just stood up on his other one. But look at the size difference. So they're both just relaxing after a little breath or bath with a little cool air. So since they both got their little legs cocked and, oh, did Ransom just tell Buddy to back up? I want to go ahead and move away and let him stand here for a little minute. Maybe he'll sit on a swing and I'll put the hose up. All right, so they're sitting out there. I'm sitting on a swing. I'm a little wet from hosing them down, but it's still freaking hot out here. I don't know where Moki's at. He's probably in the garage. Buddy's got his little back leg cocked. And they are kind of just relaxing. Well, Ransom's relaxing. Buddy looks like he's still kind of antsy. He needs to get into something. Ooh, what did Ransom see? I see the two donkeys over there, but Bell's right next to him. I don't know what he's looking at. I don't think Ransom hears too good. I don't know if they were shooting off him or whatever. But when I open this door, Buddy looks. And I go, hi, Buddy, and Ransom is still kind of clueless until I either make a loud step or say a louder name, and then he looks like, what? So I'm not sure he can hear real good. I'll have to do a test about that later. Now, I pulled Ransom up to stand close to that pole, and he wanted to back up. And Buddy's kind of backing up there, too. And I checked that pole for wasp nests, for, oh, Ransom just told Buddy, get away. There ain't no wasp nests. There ain't anything around that pole. I looked at that video more. I sent it to my vet, and he never got back to me. So he probably just said, it ain't nothing. You're being paranoid because of Mr. T. So I looked at it again, and if you go back and look at that video where it looks like Buddy had a little tremor or spasm, it looks like his either front left or front right knee locked up, and like he meant to lock it up and it didn't, and it kind of went limp and lock on him real quick, and I think that's what caused the shiver through his body. But so the flies may be getting on them now because of all that water and sweats off them. So they may have more flies now. I could spray them down before I put them out there, but I don't know how long that fly spray is going to last when it's wet. But I could probably do that. Yeah, it looks like the flies are bugging him. Buddy too. So anyway, that's giving them a bath on a hot day. It is sinking super hot. They were sweating bad. And so I just pull them into the shade and hose them off. Let them cool off a little bit. I don't shock them. I don't spray them cold everywhere real quick. I know somebody's gonna be like, I slowly get their legs and give their belly a little squirt and they kind of adjust to the temperature, and then I wash off one side a little bit and then I go the other side. And so it's not traumatic for them by no means. What are you guys doing? See, my fan just kicked on my attic. I've got a fan up there that sucks air out of the attic if it gets to 110 in the attic, and it just kicked on. And it usually only kicks on maybe 10 times out of the year. It'll be 100 degrees out there and it won't kick on. So it has something to do with the sunlight, the humidity, something, because sometimes it's hot as hell and it doesn't kick on. And then other times, like right now, there's a light little breeze and I'm sitting in a shade and it's not too bad, and it just kicked on. So I'm not sure how that buddy's playing with his rope. Like, dude, untie this sucker. I'll let you guys go if you want to go back in the sun. I just figured you want to stand in the shade a little bit. All that water on the mats there probably cooled off the mats. And so little Belle just walked forward. That's what you saw, Ransom's alert. She walked like 20 paces forward and looked at him. So Ransom's more locked onto her and concerned about her than he is, than Buddy. Buddy's good. The more they kind of nudge each other and do shit next to each other, the better for me. Because Ransom will learn how to push back, and he won't let Buddy take over that damn stall like he does. Get him, Ransom. You're all right. I know. I want you to get him. He don't listen to me either. Maybe you can get him to listen. So you see my little wind spinner there spinning lightly. It's pretty mild. I'm going to say it's a 2 to 3 mile an hour wind. But any breeze feels good in this heat. So especially because they're like wet, it probably really feels good. Oh, I'm checking my email earlier today, and sometimes new emails will pop on while I'm checking it. And that little, that McCarthy girl, whoever that I freaking blocked doing the live yesterday, because she was like, oh, poor Rick being a smart ass. So I said, okay, I'll just block you. I feel better now. She had to email me and tell me that she's a better trainer than me, and it doesn't take her an hour to train a horse. So I must not know what I'm doing. So it's that lashing out. I got to prove myself better and prove that, you know, that typical little insecure women that like to run around and say how powerful and strong they are. They got blocked. So now I'm going to come back and tell him he don't know how to train a horse and I can do it faster than him. Sure you can, little darling. You just keep thinking that, and you go out there and you train your little. That's why you're hanging out on my site, right? Because you can train a horse faster than me. Okay. And whether or not it's faster or not doesn't matter. I can take a long time or a short time depending on the horse circumstances, how much I want to accomplish, how hard I want to push it, and how critical it is to teach it. Teaching fast is actually usually worse. But you already know that because you're smart. Aww. Rick blocked her and now she's smarter than him. Okay. I swear, man, these freaking people, I mean, it's just more and more I want to just totally disconnect. Don't read the comments. Don't allow comments. Don't do live. Make my damn videos and take it or leave it, and I don't give a shit, and nobody gets to say anything, and nobody gets to ask questions. I'm moving closer and closer to there. Fan on the roof is loud. I don't know if y'all can hear it, but it's pretty stinking loud. I was gonna move the hose, and when I was moving it, I got a phone call So I came and sat on the swing, took the phone call. And I can't videotape while I'm on a phone, on the iPhone. And I get asked this probably 100 times a year. No, the fire hydrant is not real. I did a video where I painted it, where I bought it, what it looked like before, what it looks like now, and I set it on that brick. There is no water. The only water comes from my well over there, and the pipes are underground. Now, I guess I could run a little bitty line to that and make it a real fire extinguisher like it has water, but it's never gonna have more pressure than my hose because my system is what it is. And a little rabbit was out this morning, but man, he digs in when it gets this hot. If I see him out, I squirt him with the hose a little bit. He don't like it, he runs off, but at least he gets wet. I know it cools him off. It's kind of funny that Ransom has the whole side open to his, to my left over here. He's got all this open and he moves to the right to kind of put pressure on Buddy. So I don't know if he's putting pressure on Buddy, if he's claiming ground, if he's holding ground and saying, I'm not going to let you push me to this open area. I don't know what his thought process of standing that way. They're stomping a lot, so the flies must be getting on him. And his tail's getting a little more active. So I'm going to go spray him down. He still don't like that damn fly spray. He's still a pain in the butt about it. But I'm going to put the hose up, put some fly spray on him, and then I'll let him out in pasture.